This is a Toyota RAV4. This little car has been causing more trouble than it's got any right to cause lately. The problem is, as you're driving down the highway, the car seems to start to lose power gradually. And eventually, it doesn't even want to move. So after the car is shut off and it sits for a while, it starts up again and drives okay for a while, and then the same problem happens again. At first we suspected an engine problem, but there are no trouble codes detected with the engine. In fact, the only two codes detected have to do with the ABS. They are the C1223 and the C1246, and this gave us a clue about what was going on. So if we drive the car around the block a few times, bring it into the shop, put it on the lift, then it's almost impossible to rotate any of the wheels. So with no brake pressure being applied, there's just no way to even budge any of these four wheels, front or rear. And if we check in the live data, this master cylinder pressure sensor, which has a range of 0 to 5 volts. When the problem is occurring, this master cylinder sensor seems to be stuck at a value of about 0.6, 0.7 volts. And this is with no brake pedal pressure being applied. So with this combination of symptoms and diagnostics, the factory service manual suggests that we must replace the ABS module on this car. The ABS module is buried all the way back here. I don't know if you can even see it. There. It's down in there. So let's get to it. So this is a ABS unit that came from salvage, and it's just to illustrate what we have to work with. You have the four lines going out to the wheels. You have the lines from the master cylinder. You have the harness. And this bracket holds the ABS unit to the frame of the car. So let's start with this harness connector. You just squeeze and pull upward on the harness connector. Okay, and as you pull upward, this releases the harness from the ABS. And this is how you would do it on the car. This one has been cut, obviously. Now, these lines, they're 10 millimeter. Take a their lens, and this one I've already loosened. It can take, usually not too hard to loosen these up if they're stuck so hard that this wrench is slipping over them. Here's what you do. You take a locking vice grip, you lock it around the nut, and then you just knock it loose, break it loose. And this is the best way to break one loose if it's over tight. So we just remove all the lines. Okay, so we got the harness released, we got all the lines released. We just need to do this on the car, on the unit that's on the car. And then we can install this replacement unit. Now I've removed the battery and the airbox, and I have better access to the ABS unit. And it looks like it's not going to be too much trouble. These are turning pretty easily. So I'm going to remove them one by one in sequence. And I'm going to put a catch can down underneath to catch any drippings. I'm going to put it on the floor underneath and just let whatever comes out of here drip down to the catch can. So there, the ABS module has been freed from everything, including the harness and all the input and output lines. And the three bolts that hold the bottom of the bracket have to be reached from underneath the car. You reach in with a long extension from the center of the car above the cross member, and they are 12 millimeter hex head nuts. Okay, and you undo the nuts, and then the ABS module can come off the supporting studs. And one final thing I remove is this harness support bracket that sits on top of the motor mount, and it's just in the way of the ABS. So I take it out. It just has one 10 millimeter bolt holding it to the motor mount or transmission mount. Okay, so now with the harness and the harness support out of the way, the ABS will come right out. So the replacement ABS is bolted in and is connected to the harness. And now we must reconnect the lines one by one. And the thing you must absolutely avoid when doing this is do not cross thread any of these fittings. Okay, so start them by hand and make sure you can make a couple of turns just using hand finger pressure before you apply any tools. If you just start tightening them with a tool, then chances are you'll cross thread the soft metal. I want to reiterate to you that you must not cross thread these fittings. And the secret to not cross-threading them is they must thread in just by hand. You must be able to make several turns with almost no resistance. Okay, and only then, after you've made several turns with no resistance, do you start using a tool. But if you pull out your tool and start using it at the very first sign of resistance, like after you've barely made a half turn, then you're guaranteed you're going to cross thread your ABS unit, and you're going to be in a world of hurt, let me tell you, because I've fixed these for people who've cross threaded them. It's not fun. I get paid to do it though. Now we get to the fun part, which is to fill and bleed the brake system. We're going to start with the master cylinder. We're going to bench bleed the master cylinder on the car. And to do this, I've fashioned these little fittings, some discarded fittings and some tubing. And you can see that I've put one of them on the master cylinder already. It goes into the master cylinder, and then it loops back into the reservoir. And I'm gonna install the second one on the second port of the master cylinder in the same way. And then when I fill the reservoir, I can move the pedal back and forth gently, and this will purge all the air out of the master cylinder. There I've got both bleed hoses threaded in and looped back into the master cylinder reservoir. I started with very short strokes of the pedal and then progressively longer strokes until I made several full-length strokes of the brake pedal. And now looking back, there are no bubbles visible in the hoses, so this means that we successfully purged all the air out of the master cylinder. Now if you're wondering how I'm gonna undo these fittings without everything draining out, well, I'm just gonna put this cap back on top of the reservoir, and this provides a seal, so very little, if any, will drip out when I remove the fittings. To bleed the brakes, I use this method. I put a hose on the bleeder nipple. I run it into a bottle that is partially filled with brake fluid. I crack open the nipple. And then I go pump the pedal a bunch of times and then I return and close the nipple. It could take a few trips around all four brakes doing this, but eventually the pedal will turn hard. Be vigilant when you're doing this bleeding method that you do not let the master cylinder reservoir run dry. You will be running a lot of fluid through the system, so keep checking it in between bleeds and refill it as necessary. At the end of two trips around the car this time, the pedal turned rock hard. So I'm just going to do one more trip around the car and call it good. It's all buttoned up again. Time to test drive it and check the diagnostics. So I've got the engine running and I'm looking at the live data from the ABS. Right here is the master cylinder sensor voltage. Now I'm going to press the brake and you can see pretty quick response, and the voltage goes up when I press the brake, and as soon as I release the brake it comes back down. And this is very different from what was happening before we replaced the ABS module. Okay, so this seems more like normal behavior on this sensor, whereas before the sensor was just sticking and the value is not changing very much. Test drive is done. We've checked for any DTCs on the ABS, everything normal. Checked live data on the ABS, everything normal. So we're all done with this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video.